Hi friends, this is Soft Reason. In this lesson, we will be looking at foundation design of this mass communications network stand. As you can see, I have run analysis and design of this mass communication stand. Okay, so we are going to be looking at the foundation design. Okay, so for us to do that, we will click on foundation design. Once you click on it, these are the loadings and also the load combinations. We want to include all these loads, okay? And so you click on include all, okay? And so then you click on start foundations advanced. You click on it and you will wait for some time so it loads. Alright, so it is doing loading, okay? Alright, so this is what we will have. So we'll be having around foundations, okay? And so the first thing we need to do, we have to come to these load factors. And under this load factor, we will have generate load combination, okay? You click on it. You will have this, and then you have to select your codes, okay? I will be using British here, okay? And then in the service load combination, you click on generate load combinations. Load combinations generation completed. Okay, it then in the ultimate load combination you generate as well. You okay it. Alright, and then you close this. The next thing you need to do, you have to now go to job setup. You will click on job setup and then you click on create new job. I will have to expand this. In the create new job, you give the job a name. I will give it Raft as a name, okay? And then in the job type, I will select math, okay? Because we are dealing with Raft Foundation, okay? Then the design code is British. Then we have the SI unit to be this, okay? And so what we need to do here is we have to include all these rules, okay? Using this button. You click on it, all right, and you click on create job. All right, this is job raft has been successfully created, and then you click on OK. Then you expand this. Once you expand the first thing you need to do, you go to mesh generation. You click on it. Once you click on mesh generation, you expand add meshing region, okay? And then we want to use a rectangle, okay? A kind of a square like a mat footage, okay? Then you click on add. Once you click on add, you will notice that this particular rectangular regions will show. So we need to fill in the length of this foundations and the width as well as the coordinates. So for us to get the length and the width, we will go back to our start, okay? And then we will go to utility. Under utility, you will see node 2. And then you select node distance. So you can be able to get the distance from this node to this node, okay? This is 3.1. From this node to this node, it is also 3.1, okay? And so the next thing, you go back to the start foundation page. Then we are having 3.1 here, but we want to,
okay, let's fix in the 3.1, okay? And then the width also is 3.1.
Now the coordinate, okay, so that we can fix this at the exact place, okay? So we want to go back to check our coordinates, okay? The X and Z coordinates. You go back to the start, okay? You escape this, you double click on this node. Sorry.
You select the node cursor, go to select and activate the node cursor, then click on this node, double click it. You will see that in the X we have 20.92902
and in the Z we have -21.805, okay?
So this figure is what we'll put in there, okay? Then we'll go back there and in the Z coordinate we are having 20.902, okay? Then in the Z coordinate we were having 21.805, okay? So this is what we are supposed to have, okay? But if we input this, we will be having a rectangular shape that will link this according to these points, okay? But we want to have an offset so as to take care of overturning, okay? So that offset we want to have 1 meter. So if you add 1 meter to 3.1, you will be having 4.1. You add 1 meter, you will be also be having 4.1, okay? And
How do we do on the corner so you can have the exact placement?
What we need to do is half of this 1 meter is
0.5.
And so we are going to be subtracting this value
from 0.5. Okay,
so 20.902 minus 0.5. You'll be having 20.402. Okay, so here we'll be having 4. Okay, then if you subtract it from here, you will notice that you'll be having 22 because this one is already carrying minus sign.
Minus 21.805 minus 0.5. You'll be having 22.
You'll be having 22.305.
Okay,
22.305.
This is what you'll be having. And then you say, click on. Okay, you give it the region a name. Let's call it region 1, meaning arrow 1. Okay, and so you will click on add region. So this is exactly what we are expecting. Okay,
so after which you will go to machine setup. You click on it.
In the machine setup, you will click on add this region. We just give a name. Okay, you click it, will appear here. You click on it here. Okay, and then you click on machine.
And we are going to use quad lateral machine. Okay, and then we click on OK. So the machine has been done successfully. Okay, so the next thing we need to do, we expand this analysis properties. Okay, you click on it to expand it. Then this slab thickness.
All right, we are going to be considering 300 mm by 300 mm for both analysis and design. You can change it. Okay, you can change it. Okay, you go to soil property. In this soil property, what we'll be looking at is the soil grade modules. Okay, the soil height will be also fixed in our soil height to be 1.3 as given. All right, 1.3. All right, it's a meter. Is that so? We are going to look at this our soil grade. In soil grade, you click on it and then you click on calculate subgrade modulus from soil bearing capacity. You click on it. The soil bearing capacity of this is 85. Okay, kilonewton meter square. Okay, 85. Okay, then you click on calculate. Once you click on calculate, you'll be having 10 to 100. Okay, and then you had. All right, this is our subgrade. Okay, modulus. All right, so after which, what you need to do is
you will go to math analysis slash design option.
You expand it and then you click on analysis. Once you click on analysis, you say yes, and then you click on save and allow the program to analyze the foundation.
So the analysis is completed.
You can see the warning and the result, and we have to close this, okay, dialog. Once you click it, yes, that's already giving us our analysis and design calculations, okay? You can see, okay?
So we have to proceed to output view options.
You click on output view option, okay? Then you go back to geometric, all right? And so in this place, you can see it in 3D by clicking on this draw 3D, okay? So this is the thickness and how it's going to be, all right? Go back to draw lines diagram, okay, and you can also show your soil pressure, okay, by clicking this point. All right, so these are the soil pressure, okay, in respect to the load, okay. All right, after which you can also show the soil stress even at this point by selecting these options, okay, to get your soil stress. Okay,
finally you go to moment envelope.
All right, in this moment envelope you will have to use ultimate loads only. Okay, you click on maintain ASPA ratio and then you can then click on generate moment. All right, so this is the moment in respect to the load apply. Okay,
you go to slab designer. Okay,
in this slab designer you cannot change your grade. Okay, I want to use 410 instead of 460. Okay,
so I change here. This place I want to use 225.
Okay,
I want to use 250. Okay, well, the cover is 50 top and bottom. Okay,
so the pedestrian cover also is 250. We don't have anything like that, but let's just change it. Okay, and so the reinforcement size slab main bar minimum I want to use 12 and slab maximum
we want to use 16, okay? Alright, so reinforced spaces, okay? I want to use 250, okay? Then minimum is 100, okay? So I will click on consider wood and armor moment, okay? Then click on it and click on design. Design processed. You okay it, alright? You want to view the output, you click on the summary, okay? You can see the design summary has been done successfully, okay? At the moment, okay, the area required, this is the area of steel. From here, you can get your steel, you divide this by the diameter of steel to get your steel, okay? Alright, if this is Y16 or this is Y12, okay? And then you can get a detail report as well. This is very top, this is a detail report that you can print using this point, okay? You can also check for punching shear, okay? You check for, this is longitudinal, okay? You can see the value. We have 720 millimeter square per meter, okay? As the value in a the longitudinal direction. If you check the transverse directions, it will also give you value, different values, okay? Some of the values are similar to the longitudinal, okay? You can check the top side of it, okay? And also the bottom side, okay? You can also check for punching, okay? You click here, punching shear. Alright, you see pass, design state to pass, okay? So, these are the things we can print, okay? And add it to your report. You close this page, okay? So we are done with that. You go to reinforcement zoning, okay? In the reinforcement zoning, you can select longitudinal top or transverse top or transverse bottom and then you zoom it, okay? Click on zoom. Alright, so this is the zoning diagrams, okay? So, that is that. You can also cut your slabs, okay, as well. Like if you click on, if you use, you can by drawing a line on slab or by specifying coordinate. Can you coordinate here? Specify coordinate where to be able to cut this for you, or you can click on by drawing a line. And then you click and you draw a line across this. Okay, just the way I'm doing. That's it. Okay, you click on it. Alright, once you click on it and then you said extract new cut. The cut has been extracted. You can see, okay, you can click on design selected lines. So these are the selected line as we designed, okay? So you can see the selected grid lines, okay? Moment envelope, area of steel, set design parameter, okay? So you click on, you can see area of steel now is 0. When you design this selected line, you will notice that this area of steel will now be having a values or figures, okay? So you can now click on design for ultimate load type only, okay? And you click on set design parameter. In this set design parameter, you also change this the way we use in the other site, okay? 410 and FCU is 25, okay? 25 and the cover we use 50 and 50, okay? The reinforcement we will use 12 and 16, okay? And the spacing we use 250 and 100, okay? And so you say consider wood and armor moment, okay? And you click on OK. After which, what you need to do is you click on design. Now that you have designed, you can see there is no difference between when the slab was designed and now, okay? You can see the reinforcement top and bottom 750, okay? So you can see you now move to the area, reinforcement area, okay? These are the reinforcement area, okay? So that is how it works. So you can print these informations, okay? And you closed. Alright, so the next thing you will be looking at is moment capacity check. You will click on moment capacity check. With this value, okay, you can plot your capacity diagram, okay, in the longitudinal direction. You click on it. So this is the moment capacity diagram with a key, okay, moment capacity, okay, including newton meter per meter, okay? Alright, so after we click on your calculation sheet. Once you click on calculation sheet, it will take you to your detailed calculations, okay? You can see your detailed calculations. Design of math foundations. Math foundation designs to BS8110 metrics. You can see the job is raft, okay? So what you are having here is include supports, okay? And you are having your X direction and Y direction, the value we input, which is the size of the math, okay? These are your calculations, all right? So these are your calculations that you attach to your design, okay? If this lesson has helped you in one way or the other, kindly subscribe, okay, for more video. And also, if you have any questions concerning this, you can ask, okay?
in the comment section. When you click on this point, it will print your calculation sheet. Okay, once you print your calculation sheet, you will have it in PDF just like this. Okay, so this is your calculations just like this. Okay, kindly subscribe my channel for more detailed video in engineering software of this kind. Okay, so we are going to stop here, but let's look at some other options. We will have graphed here. Okay, the graph was not plotted, and our GA drawing, we have to refresh. Once you refresh, you have a GA drawing. Okay, this is the GA drawing. You can see the column point. This is the offset we made 1 meter from the center of the column this way to take care of overboarding pressure. Okay, so that is the drawing. So we can also check for the graph. If you refresh this, we will still take us to this point. Okay, so this is where we are going to stop. I believe strongly that you have learned a new thing here. And if this lesson has helped you in one way or the other, kindly subscribe. Okay? And like the video. Drop your comments in the comment sections. I will reply to your comments as soon as possible. Okay? Bye for now.